will be at the end.
Here we have the individuals on the as waves on the sea of existence. So in Jung's model, every individual is a wave, and on the here you have the white on the top of the wave that could be imagined as the ego with the field of consciousness around it. Then the rest of the wave here, that is the personal unconscious, and then the ocean would be the collective unconscious. And the ego, to look briefly at these different sub-systems, the ego is that function within us that says I want, I feel, I think. It's the central chamber of comment where the data comes in and we make decisions based on the input from outside and inside. Around it is this field of consciousness that some of our experiences that we have lived through, some abilities that have become ours. And then there's the personal unconscious. Personal unconscious is a kind of a storehouse at one hand where we have put in repressed experiences. In that regard, it's quite close to what Freud saw as the personal unconscious. Jung sees it a little bit broader. He also thinks there are contents that have never reached the level of consciousness. We've never thought about it, never realized it, and it has both positive and negative qualities. Then there's the collective unconscious as the ocean. And the collective unconscious is the psyche that we share. So the collective unconscious is different than bottles of Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola is identical but separate. There where the collective unconscious is identical and the same. So we all share the same unconscious, which Jung calls the collective unconscious. And Einstein said, the notion of separation is an illusion of consciousness. And that fits in with the model that Jung gave. So in this collective unconscious, that is the home of the archetypes. There are these creatures that are influencing our lives. And an archetype is a dynamic pattern of behavior and a living organism. And the goal is to get aware of these creatures and live in accordance with their energy patterns. So I have here a model from Marie-Louise von Franz, who is a close worker with Jung. And it looks a little bit like the model that that Sunny made of the archetypal psyche. And Jung thought, or von Franz said in this case, but that here on A, here is are the individuals. And so you have differentiation at the edges and sameness at the center. And in B, then the personal unconscious, now you have a kind of a layer where the family unconscious is, where you see these same family traits with these other people in your house. And here's the nationwide unconscious, and this is the central pool with archetypes, with our patterns of behavior. And Adolf Bastian, who is an anthropologist out of the late 1900s, and he traveled a lot. And what he noticed on his travels were that there are a lot of similar experiences by men. And so wherever he went, people had to deal with marriage, with death, with birth, with fear, with types of making a journey, having a home, and going through all these different life stages. And he noticed that people had stories, mythology, fairy tales, that portrayed in their local costume the same themes that all people deal with. And so, for example, there is in Poland a story about a wolf in the deep, dark forest. And in Indonesia, there is a story about a shark in the deep blue ocean. And they both represent this element of tremendous aggression in the depths of our own being, as well as what we experience in nature. And so you see that these similar experiences at the core of being human have different costumes all across the world. And you wove further on that concept of it and said the archetypes are in that central pool providing, or are those, let's say, are that image that stands behind the wolf and the shark, and that comes into the culture as a shark, as a wolf. And so it is he sees it as a kind of a transcendental position out of which aggression comes, or the idea of marriage, or the inner idea of the woman or man in the other. And so we go to the archetypes. The archetypes are important because they are the living dynamic.